Hi, I'm Lily Collins, and I'm going to take you through a scene from Emily in Paris, shot by shot. So the beginning shot of Emily walking across the street where it starts on her shoes and goes up and you see the opera house, that was a really hard one to coordinate because we had to stop traffic. It's a pretty heavy traffic area and also pedestrian area. And we were shooting at night, so it was a little less crowded, but harder to stop all of the cars. So our entire camera crew was in front of the opera house, but all the way back. And then they were on the ground, tilted down at my shoes, and then had to like work their way up and had to coordinate their tilting at the same time as me running. So we had to coordinate those two things at the same time. And we had to try and control some of the city lights, which is, as you know, it's a city of lights, Paris is known for. So that's really difficult. But having to light the opera house in exactly the right way and have all the background interact in a very specific way to part the waves in order for me to then enter into the door. So we did it quite a few times, but we also couldn't hold traffic up. So I think we did it probably in like 15 minutes. And then once I made it into the opera house, all of the camera crew were behind me and it was on a dolly shot. And they had to go to the side and watch me as a profile enter into the frame. It was definitely a bit of a dance between the camera crew and I. There were so many things to coordinate. There were so many people in the background. There were so many camera angles and camera shots to get within this scene to kind of amplify the beauty of the location.
Emily, you look beautiful in that dress, but not as beautiful as you look without it.
Well, you're looking pretty handsome yourself.
So this standoff was actually written a couple different ways, or rather we did it a couple different ways. It was always supposed to be on the steps where you're looking up at the two of them, kind of on equal levels, but he, Thomas' character, always felt like he was a little bit above Emily in a sense. So there was also trying to be a bit of an element of playing with that, like height and feeling quite above and looking down on Emily. And playing with the camera angles on that one.
So now we have a bad ballet and an awkward encounter with an overrated designer to look forward to?
Oh my God, you are a snob.
Excuse me?
You really just don't like to like anything, do you?
We wanted it to stay playful and not too aggressive because that's just not who Emily is, but she also is like quite passionate.
You go and I'll meet you afterwards and I'll treat you to some amazing sex. I think we'd both like that better.
Thomas. Since you're a professor of science, I'm sure you won't have any trouble recognizing this one.
In this specific moment, it wasn't always planned that the sign that he would be reading was that. There was some dialogue written instead. And then we thought, well, let's just be extra sassy and give a bit of a finger. And then they ended up keeping it. So there were so many different ways of playing it.
That's more of a gesture. Do I know you?
So this is Emily's second standoff of the night with Pierre Cadot, who is an incredibly eccentric character who I loved so much.
I just came here to apologize for the other day for offending you and to let you know that you're right. I am a basic bitch with a bad charm.
I, in my mirror, had gone over this scene over and over again and said the speech a million times. But once we were on set, I think we did one rehearsal and then just started rolling because it was really late and I kind of just wanted to get it all out before I got too tired.
In fact, do you want to know why I got that bag charm? Because my friends and I were obsessed with Gossip Girl. We all wanted to be Serena Vanderwoodson in her gorgeous, crazy expensive couture. But the only thing we could afford from any of those designers was a clip-on bag charm from a outlet mall in Winnetka.
So we played this a couple different ways. Some where it was quicker and faster in the way that I said it, but then that seemed a little bit unfair for the character to have to kind of listen to her verbally kind of go crazy at Pierre Cadeau. And then I kind of found like a happy medium where Emily's frustrated at the situation, but she's also understanding of Pierre's perspective, but she just admits that she is kind of exactly what he thinks she is. And she is determined to explain to him why that's actually a good thing.
You think Ringguards don't respect designers? We worship designers so much that we spend all we've saved on a dumb accessory just to feel like we're somehow on your runway. You may mock us, but the truth is, you need us. Without basic bitches like me, you wouldn't be fashionable.
I can't believe it was Dan.
What?
Gossip Girl. We watched the entire series to find out. It's Dan.
The lovely man playing Pierre Cadeau actually, and ironically, didn't know much about Gossip Girl and didn't really know who Dan Humphrey was, which made it kind of funny to explain to him in that scene. But he got it. He got it right away. And I just love that Emily and Pierre are able to connect on such a pop iconic TV show. And I think it just allowed the two of them to have something in common. I truly believe that Emily grew up loving Sex and the City. She loved 90210. She loved Gossip Girl. It's like all those shows that I know that I grew up watching. So for her and Pierre to have that in common allowed Emily, I think, to ultimately win him over.